have a Lee Sin and a LeBlanc that's this far behind, things are going to be bad. What are they...
We got the rotation coming in here. No TP available. Okay. Gorilla is eating up a lot of this aggro. They're trying to get on top of Root. The Q comes in.
Oh, please.
And wait.
Oh, wait, close what? Your eyes.
Well, he got the late Vigil, but it's not enough damage.
Fight, especially inside of Taric ultimate.
And also there's a lot of AoE damage coming out, so you are going to get a lot of value there.
Parallel Convergence comes in, BDD with the perfect life and stun! Out of the Echo, Mystic has nowhere to go. BDD with complete control of the team fight. Cosmic Radiance just for good measure. Another Dazzle comes down. Life having a brilliant game so far, as well as Spirit and Fly.
And for Ghost. And there's the dash on forward. Chains do land. Is Barrel.
Whoa, that is the longest Zenith Blade I have ever seen. Showmaker trying to...
That is definitely...
Well, they're trying to burst
very, very close.
They're trying to burst it. Yeah. Totemon Prince is one team that will actually burst things. And now Iksu in a really awkward spot. He got the junglers in the pit. It is going to go the way of Flawless, and that will be the Cloud Soul on the way here for Sonewon. You can see that even Aphelios is really fast, but now they're just in a corner. And it's up to 200 years to try to fight out of it, but Flawless, he's going to get hooked down. And Hybrid in the front is so much. That is a big stopwatch, but yeah.
Oh yes, it is!
It is more than enough as he's going to take down so many of them. Mr. Years, hello, comes in and shuts them all down. And now Vicky is just going to pick up this last kill. There's the ace. Sandbox can hardly believe it.
It's just going to be very comfortable for Canyon to move over with Shirley. Not sure why Ghost walked out of the lane, but is going to die. And Afrika get rewarded for staying there. But oh my goodness. Barrel, remember, does not have his ultimate, but Noggery has his! As the Slicing Maelstrom launches itself into the backline, an easy triple kill is banned.
Oh,
the fadeaway!
Banner.
Quadra kill comes out as now Fly. He's going to need to get over it.
You can see, they know about Syndra.
Yeah, well, Canyon's just walking around, having a great time. This game is just super weird. As Showmaker, oh my goodness, he does a lot of damage, but not if he hits the minion wave.
Oh!
A bubble!
Woo!
Oh, collected by the Syndra! That's her first death, and Showmaker puts her in the grave. As that Yuumi face is exactly what I was... I didn't know there was Monka S in League of Legends.
Anyways, great news. Speed at E. Getting
chunked.
Teddy.
Yeah, answering back nicely.
Teddy.
Drew Barrage also able to do some work as Rascal might need to use the ultimate just for zoning.
They're bursting it.
Yeah, this Mountain Drake going to get taken down very low. The Ren should be enough here as Rascal. Will he be able to get the knockback? No, he's not. As the Ornn is taken down. Yes, they get the Drake, but T1 now looking for the team fight. BDD still bouncing around, finds another bubble.
Ruler's
hopping back. So many sticks into all the members of T1. But can he actually close distance? Teddy's still huge. As another bubble connects onto Faker here, and Ruler knows that he needs to take matters into his own hands. BDD still alive, but Teddy, every time BDD steps forward, Teddy's there with a Mystic Shard. But it looks like Gen.G will be able to get out. It's a one trade here for T1, one for two. But I think that they're just going to be able to get out. Okay, Cuz, full health bar, teleport in from T1 as BDD trying to get some more work done. Cuz, that's Faker, actually, who's been back to base. Oh, that was not the one that I was expecting it to be. As bubble connects onto the Ola. BDD looks for it but doesn't find it. Zhonya's utilized here, teleport in. This fight is extending so long as Clid goes golden, and Rascal looks for Faker. Canna into the backline. BDD survives though as Canna falls down, and Rascal gets a huge knock up. Faker still trying to get in amongst it as there's all the knock ups, and Faker is eventually taken down.
Eddie?
This hyper extended team fight will eventually go in favor of Gen.G with a triple kill from Ruler at the very end.
Flanking or just going in front, maybe that's not a great choice.
Yeah, I mean, Iksu is actually pretty tanky, and the amount of poke they're able to do is really nice so far. But here comes
Warman.
A magnificent taunt into the back line, and they're going to take on the top Kench right from the get-go. Dudu pretty low, but it doesn't seem to matter, as Miru's going to get in and get another kill there, another taunt, rather, as the concussive blows will come in, and Iksu will eventually die. The double kill will go to Viper, but Miru essentially carrying the team on his back. They finally, but he was still untouchable. Even besides all that, there was a big backline dive by the side of T1. And from that team fight, they're going to try to roll into this Infernal and take it away real quick. I think they should be able to.
Yep, they got some spooky ghosts. Oh my god, life! Oh, that was insane. I think it was with a smite from his unsealed spellbook, but the range may not have quite been enough as Faker is going to execute Rascal. But Ruler will have an arcane shift, and that's all he's going to need to be able to take down Faker from the mid lane.
There's Summit. All right, Arrow going to pierce the heavens. Looks like Outer Turret will be claimed here, though, as Shockwave pulls back only Tucson. Hook is going to connect onto his opposite number there, and he has to go golden. Good double knockup, but aiming not exactly going to take too much damage. Now Kuro looks for the backline. Shockwave onto one, as there goes the cannon. And look at all of the years coming out of aiming. He's not exactly the main one in this fight, but he's still able to tidy up. Summit, I mean, he's pretty tanky, but it does not matter. As yes, they managed to take down Tucson, but the rest of the team gets obliterated. Aiming, even able to find the Gravitum, and now Root's going to be dead. That's the ace. I think it's still the fastest game on record in international players. There's a Cyclone towards the bottom side of the map. Mystic throws out his arrow. Beryl probably bit off more than he could chew, but don't worry. They're so far ahead that it doesn't matter. Canyon holding onto this minion wave. Oh. Piercing Darkness doing so much. Double kill with a Dawning Shadow. And Canyon's still standing there. They've thrown out angry bees. Spirits trying to run away. Ragnarok has been popped, and Fly walking on over with his soccer ball.
Powerful that game. And I guess the problem is that he's playing Volibear, right? So it's just...
Yeah, we can't...
Do we do those? Do we do those? What? Oh, my.
Oh, the Volibear.
Was that a Volley ult?
That
was
Volibear ult.
That was his Stormbringer?
Yeah.
They
go for the triple inhibitor. They get it.
Look at this turret. I mean, this is like a paper turret. They can poke it once. Just going to let the cannon do the job. That's a lot of poke, though, and they get the knock-up on aiming in the back line. Is this T1's chance? That's a nice knock-up from Smep, though.
Oh!
Huge Moonlight Vigil with the AoE damage on the back.
Nice!
T1 might have done it. They're going to turn it around. Aiming is going to go down. Kuro and Bano somehow getting away in Tucson. It's gonna buy a little bit of time, but now it's...
I'm just really surprised. You know, this is times where Bard would be so cool with magical journeys, like running.
Oh, man!
Oh.
Wait, what was that? He missed... Okay, he got the flash out of Kuro, but now
Kuz!
That is a really big stopwatch, but can they do anything Woo! From it? The flash is not enough. That is a big knockup on a Teddy, but everybody's bunched up for the Aphelios to just auto them in their face as aiming is desperate to get value. He's going to survive, but the Death Stand is going to get him in the back, and I think T1 have done it.
I'm looking at my boy Def. He's doing pretty good this game.
Alice, come on. What's going on?
We'll have a look at this team.
Pay attention.
The teleport is coming in. That's a big taunt. Lands onto a few members, but double QSS gets him out of the way. Cubate dies as an afterthought. That is Chobi picking up that kill. Well indicated.
Double
That's
kill.
A double. Are we looking for the pentakill? Could this save the player of the game vote?
Yes,
it may just as Chobi finds the triple. Heroic entrance to deliver the quadra to the Corki as he goes golden for a moment. Of course they're going to give it to him. No, they're not.
What?
Deft is going to steal it away. Is now a Viper. He's gone onto the fountain. He's not given any quadra kills or double kills over to these two members of DRX. Unless Deft has something to say about it, Nexus turret's now going to be taken low as the Karma steals that last kill, then throws herself into the void afterwards.
He can't farm the bottom side of his jungle.
Oh. Gotta be real careful.
Okay. Yeah, there is a ward here in the brush, but it is a red ward. Lee Sin is going to spot the set. We got a bit of a duel here in the jungle.
Sandbox is going to win this.
Wow, look at Summit just winning the 1v1. All of a sudden, Flawless, it almost looks like he was sacrificing himself, but the Q comes in. Hot Bling is going to take it, and they're going to get the double kill. Mickey coming in, trying to get that combo, but I think he got stunned at the same time. Not able to make it happen, and that is two kills for Sandbox.
And Sandbox just blow everything. What is going on, man?
A stun. And Summit's going to get away too. That's flash blown. You guys can see that DRX are currently on the throne of the number one team in the LCK.
Yeah.
Ooh.